हाय एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ रोहित कुमार मिश्रा, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेटलर्जिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ BIT सिंदरी। माय टॉपिक इज़ अल्ट्रा लो कार्बन स्टील मेकिंग यूजिंग लाइफ साइकिल असेसमेंट। दीज आर द आउटलाइंस ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन। द आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री इज़ वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट इंडस्ट्रियल एनर्जी कंज्यूमर, अकाउंटिंग फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 20-45% ऑफ टोटल इंडस्ट्रियल एनर्जी डिमांड इन मैनी कंट्रीज। एंड सिंस इंडिया इज़ स्टिल अ डेवलपिंग कंट्री, इट इज़ मोर चैलेंजिंग टू फाइट द CO2 एमिशन प्रॉब्लम इन आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री। In this presentation, we will see how life cycle assessment plays a vital role in making ultra low carbon steel, which is a breakthrough technology in iron and steel industry, and we'll also see its different types. First of all, let's take an overview of Indian steel industry. India is currently the second largest producer of crude steel and produced 111 million tons of crude steel last year. We can clearly see that there was a decline of 14.1% in the production of pig iron, which was about 5.51 million ton, but was the largest producer of sponge iron in 2019. The global steel production is estimated to grow by 30% by 2050, where the production will be more from secondary steel than primary steel. Developed countries have stocks of 12 to 13 tons per capita, but India have steel stock of 1 ton per capita. It is estimated by International Energy Agency that the global demand of steel could rise from 1.6 gigaton in 2015 to 2.2 gigaton by 2050, and for India it is likely to grow in coming decades. Today about 95% of primary steel is produced in blast furnace, which use coking coal, and only 5% new steel is produced by direct reduction of iron combined with electric arc furnace, which use syngas. As it is estimated that in future there will be more production using secondary steel, therefore, current and future volume of production depends on different reasons and routes. Steel industry is facing lots of problems due to this huge emission of CO2. Around 1.8 tons of CO2 is produced per ton of steel. It is estimated to rise up to 3.1 gigaton per annum by 2050. And for India, as per its ongoing demand, it is estimated to rise 3 times by 2050, that is from 242 million ton to 837 million ton. There has been lots of technological advancement, which includes increase in energy efficiency in steel making process and improvement in steel recycling rates. There has been increased recycling and utilization of co-product, and there has been also an extensive process automation for precise control of steel making. But we still need some breakthrough technologies for future. Now, coming next to life cycle assessment. It is an environmental assessment method for evaluation of impact that a product, process or technology has on the environment over the entire period of its life. From the extraction of raw material through the manufacturing, packaging and marketing process, the use, reuse and maintenance of product or technology to its eventual recycling or disposal as waste at the end of its useful life. LCA in particular provides a new perspective on product and process. It examines the industrial system and evaluates their performance starting from the extraction of raw material through all different operations until their final disposal as waste back into the ecosystem. The European steel industry has created a group of industries and research organizations that have developed some breakthrough technology for ultra-low carbon steel making process and has the potential of meeting the target of reduction of greenhouse gas emission. LCA method has undertaken this process as the most holistic approach to reduce CO2 emission by 50%. But the production of CO2 will still be there, and to overcome this, we need to capture it and store it. For carbon capture and storage, we need some technical solution for cleaning and transporting the gas through pipes to the storage site, and still need to develop. So we have some upcoming technologies. In top gas recycling, blast furnace process, carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas is recycled, leaving the blast furnace, which has the potential to act as reducing agent and thus can be recirculated to blast furnace. The whole main idea is to reduce the use of fossil carbon, which is coke and coal. The next is alcoving and alkalosis process, both of which are based on electrochemical reduction of iron oxide. Alcoving process is powered by direct electricity with NaOH as electrolyte, which produces iron and oxygen from iron ore at approximately 110 degrees Celsius. This process is emission-free if renewable electricity is used, but the production is low, and to overcome this, the iron ore is dissolved in a molten oxide solution at 1600 degrees Celsius. This is known as alkalosis. In this process, oxygen is produced at anode and iron at cathode. Coming next to Hisarna, which consists of a reactor with temperature above the melting point of iron throughout the vessel. In the cyclone, the temperature is further increased by adding pure oxygen, which react with carbon monoxide present. The iron ore melts immediately and drifts into the bottom of the vessel, where powdered coal is injected, converting the oxygen from iron ore to bind with carbon, thus producing pure liquid iron. Now, conclusion. Life cycle assessment is an appropriate method for assessing environmental impact and selecting new technologies to reduce CO2 emission in steel making process up to 50% or more. Ultra low carbon steel making and many more like Alcoz BF, Alcovin Alcolysis and Hisarna process as a part of ultra low carbon steel making is a wonderful initiative towards sustainable development of iron and steel industry. But there is always a scope of improvement. These are the references. We are still contributing to 2.57 million pounds of CO2 every second. Thank you.